Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this quick video, we'll be showing you how you can use Docker to run a Redis server in minutes. Redis is an in-memory key value database. By using memory, Redis is able to perform read and writes incredibly fast. It has a huge number of different use cases and is often used as a caching layer or a message broker. For example, we use Redis for our website to help cache database calls. This helps with the user experience as they don't have to wait for a much more time-consuming SQL call to complete. Instead, the cached response can be read incredibly fast. The steps that we are using for this guide were run on a Debian-based system, in this particular case, Ubuntu. However, as long as you have Docker installed, these steps should work on any operating system that Docker can run on. Now, on your desired system, open up the terminal, and then update the package list cache by typing in sudo apt update and then pressing enter. Once that completes, update any out of date packages on your system by typing in sudo apt upgrade hyphen y. The next step, we'll want to install the wget and kel packages by typing in sudo apt install kel and then wget and then pressing enter. If prompted, type Y and press Enter to continue with the installation. We'll be using both of these packages to make installing Docker and setting up Redis a much simpler process. And now for this first part of this tutorial, we'll be showing you how you can easily install the latest version of Docker. If you already have Docker installed, you can skip ahead. Otherwise, download and run the Docker install script by typing in kel space hyphen https://get.docker.com/pipe/sh and then press enter. Once Docker has been installed, you'll want to add your current user to the Docker group by typing in sudo /usermod /a G /docker $ and then user all in uppercase. This will allow us to manage our Redis Docker container without having to elevate to the super user every time. To ensure that this group change is read in by the rest of the system, restart by typing in sudo /reboot. Once your device has finished restarting, we can then move on to setting up our Redis Docker container. Let us start by creating a directory where we'll store the compose file for this container as well as its data. To do this, type in sudo /mkdir /p /opt/stacks/redis. The P option ensures the whole directory will be created even if one of the middle parts are missing. Now change into this new directory by typing in cd /opt/stacks/redis. We can now use the wget command to download a base compose file that will edit to suit your needs. To download this compose file, type in sudo /wget /https://git.pymylifeup.com/compose/redis/compose.yaml. With the compose file now saved to your system, we'll want to open it for editing by typing in sudo /nano /compose.yaml. The first thing you'll want to do is set the version of Redis that you'll want to run using Docker. There's a few ways that you can do this, but you need to replace the placeholder that we have here with either the version number, such as 7 or 7.4, or alternatively, if you only want the latest version of Redis, you can just type in latest. For this example, we'll be installing Redis 7, so we'll just type in the number 7. This means you'll get the latest available version of Redis 7. That might be 7.4.8 or newer. On the next line, we define the restart option so that Docker will always restart the Redis Docker container. This ensures that if anything causes Redis to crash, it will automatically be restarted, something that is crucial for a database server. On the next line, we specify the ports that we want exposed for our Redis Docker container. In this example, we are exposing port 6379, which is the default port used by Redis. This next line defines the command that will start up the Redis server that is running within the Docker container. This line has two different placeholders that we must swap out. The first is the seconds placeholder. This defines the number of seconds that Redis should wait before saving any of its data to the disk. This isn't necessarily required, but allows data to persist between restarts. For this example, we want our Redis server to save its data every 60 seconds, so we'll be replacing this placeholder with the number 60. The next placeholder you'll need to replace is the password placeholder. We specify a password to force any connecting user to have to authenticate themselves to be able to communicate with the key value store. Replace the password placeholder with a password of your choice. Make sure you make this something secure, but for this guide we'll be just using PyMyLifeUp. Finally, at the bottom of the file, we define a simple volume. This is so any of the data our Redis server saves is saved to the local machine and not lost when the Docker container restarts. Once you're done, you can save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X and then Y and then Enter. With everything now written, all we need to do to start up the Redis Docker container is to type in docker compose up hyphen D. The hyphen D option ensures that Docker will start this container up in the background. The Redis container should only take a couple of minutes to start up. Now that the Redis server is up and running within your Docker container, you can now start putting it to use. For this example, we'll install the Redis CLI and then interact with it directly. You can install this by typing in sudo apt install redis-tools and then pressing enter. If prompted, type y and press enter to continue with the installation. Now start up the Redis command line interface by typing in redis-cli. Redis will automatically attempt to connect to the local Redis server, as you can see here. But we can't perform any actions yet, as we need to authenticate ourselves. You can do this by typing in auth space followed by your password, which in our case is PyMyLifeUp. If you see the word OK appear, then you are successfully authenticated with your Redis server. Now let's test how this all works by incrementing a new key that we will call example counter. You see it returned with the value 1. Now if we continue doing this a few times, we'll slowly just increase this number. You can see that every time we run in the increment, the previous value is increased by 1. You can also grab a key by typing in get followed by your key, which in our case will be example counter. You can also get every key that is currently in use within your Redis server by typing in keys followed by single quote, then the asterisk symbol, and then a single quote. As this is a new Redis server, you can see that we currently only have one key set. Now let's verify that persistent data is working by restarting the container. First close out the Redis CLI by pressing Ctrl plus C, and then change into the directory where we wrote the compose file. This means we'll want to type in cd space slash opt slash stacks slash redis. Now restart the Docker compose stack by typing in docker compose restart and then press enter. Docker will safely shut down our currently running Redis server and then restart it. Now start the Redis command line interface again by typing in redis-cli. Then authenticate yourself by using auth followed by your password. And finally use the get command to grab the key that exists within your Redis server. If everything has worked properly, you should see a value returned. This indicates to you that persistent data is working and Redis is saving properly. The final thing we'll be showing in this tutorial is how to update your Redis server Docker container to the latest available image. Back in the terminal, change to where we wrote the compose file by typing in cd slash opt slash stacks slash redis. Now get Docker to download the latest image by typing in docker compose pull. If a new image was downloaded, you'll now need to get Docker to restart your already running container. All you need to do this is type in docker compose up hyphen D and then press enter. At this point, you should have the Redis server up and running on your device using Docker. If you like this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.